Hello YouTube, today we're looking at MacroDroid's new system settings change detector, and what that means is that when we change a setting on our device, such as brightness or volume or a number of other settings, MacroDroid can now use those as triggers to perform the actions that the rest of the macro is built to perform. Right, that's a lot of words. Let's have a look at what we're doing. So, two things to note. There's three system settings tables called System, Global and Secure, and they are the three tables that store our device's settings. Once any of those have updated, so volume or brightness and so on, detect that some settings are not stored there. Some settings are stored in databases which aren't accessible to MacroDroid. Now here we're looking at the system settings change detector. So to get to that from MacroDroid's store, I'm going to copy this so I don't have to type it again, and I'm going to show you how to get to it. So if I click the home button, as soon as you launch MacroDroid, you can click this templates button, then the search button, which is the magnifying glass, and then in my case I'm going to just paste settings change detector and then press enter and it'll load. There we go, and then that's what this one looks like. Or recently you've been able to copy and paste bits of each link. So what you used to have to do, if you was given a link and it didn't work, you used to type ID equals, which is here, and then the number. But these days you don't have to do that, you can just type the number. So instead of searching ID equals 15927, we can now just type 15927. So I'm going to do that, 15927, enter, and then it comes up. And so that number is a unique number for that particular macro, so other macros have other numbers, of course. Anyway, right, let's have a look at this. I've already got that saved in my MacroDroid thing. So right, we've got it here. So what we're going to do is, this macro itself, we've got this trigger for system settings change. So if I click that and then click configure, and we've got some options here. So we've got three tick boxes: system, secure and global. And what they are looking for, each of the three tables, so there's three tables and we've ticked to look in all three of those for different changes. We don't have to do that, we can untick one or two, or you know, as many or as little as we want. What I've done here is leaving it blank for any, which it says in the hint text here. So if I want any change to trigger this macro, whatever the change is, that's what's going to happen. Or if I want to be more specific, we can start typing things in here. So I'm going to leave this blank for now, because what we're going to do is I'm going to make some changes and I'm going to show you why that's important and what to do with them. So if we go into my settings, so I'm using two fingers to swipe right down to the notifications area and then using that to get into the settings. If I go to, let's have a look at sound, and then if I make some changes to this volume, we should notice, and we have done at the bottom, it's showing a pop-up message which is annoyingly the same colour as the settings page, but that's, I didn't customise it. Anyway, it doesn't matter, it's fine. So it's detecting the changes and then popping the message up at the bottom. So now that we know we've got the volume and it is in system by the look of it, let's just double check. saying that, and it's not appearing. Yeah, it's in system. So what we can do is, if we go in here and tick system and untick the others, and then volume, music, speaker, and then top right corner for this menu, and then save. So it's now only going to detect changes for the volume. So if I bring the volume panel up and change media volume, it's detecting the change and displaying this thing at the bottom here. Once it's disappeared, if I change another volume, so long press that by mistake, if I drag the slider, notice it's not displaying. Well, that's good, that's what we're after. And let's just double check it is still working. If I move the volume slider, there we go. Now the reason that's happening is because we are only filtering for this line. We're not filtering for anything else, it's literally just volume, it's media volume it's called. So it's where you hear the music and videos and that kind of thing from. It's different than your alarms and ringtones. It's completely different. Now there are other settings that can be detected. So if I go into settings, no, we'll have to go back and modify the macro. That's silly me. So if I tick these and then leave this blank and save. So then go back into here. There's lots of different things that we can get it to detect. So for example, if I turn the battery percentage off, so my status bar isn't showing my battery percentage anymore. That is a trigger in this case. What else have we got? If we turn Bluetooth on and off, that will trigger. We've looked at sound, do not disturb, that does. Vibrate for calls, I was looking at these ones before. Dial tones, that changes. Dial pad tones, screen lock, sound, just give it a second to load. DTMF that's popped up at the bottom is dial pad. Seems to be firing twice. I'm not quite sure why. Screen locking. Yeah, it's not triggering now. It was doing it before. So it's a new feature. It's being worked on. There we go. It's working now. So lock screen sounds. That's going to go to zero in a second because I've turned it off again. It seems to be triggering twice. I'm not just sure what I've done. I think there might be a couple of the same macro triggering. That's maybe why. Yeah, it looks like it. All of these different ones. We've got stuff in display. Nightlight. That should trigger it as well. But maybe not. Oh yeah, it is doing. There we go. Auto rotate. That's a trigger now as well. Just about everything in the settings. That is accessible via those tables. Now there is an app called Set Edit, which shows you the tables. So we've got the three tables. We've got System, Global, and System, Secure, and Global. And these are the different values and keys that are associated with this is the system table. So anything in here, we should be, there's our DTMF tone. So that's the touch dial pad tones. So anything that is living in here that changes, MacroDroid will see. That's the same as the secure table, and that's the same as global. Now, the other advantage of this trigger, the system settings change trigger, is if I click to add an action and we go system setting, we can now change the value of these different things. So here it is again, DTMF tone. So again, it's dial pad tones. We can set it to 0 or to 1 if we wanted to. So if I'd put this to 0, I like it on. We'll save it. Oops. We'll save our macro. And we'll go back to, it's under sound, I think. Let's have a look. Right, so it's on. And then it's off. Let's set it to 0. And we can make a lock, so every time that goes on, it's turned off. So if we want to lock it off, what we're doing here is we would need to be specific. So DTMF goes in here, and then we'll save it. So if we turn that on, it goes off, but it doesn't do it for this. That's because we've not the screen locking sound. That's because we've not built it to do that. So I can easily fix that. So if we put, you notice it's locked. Well, we can easily do it for the screen locking if we wanted. So what we would do for that is we would detect the change, take everything out, and save. And then go back into this macro. We'll have to turn it off and on again. Let's have a look. Off. On. Right, we're detecting the change, so we can change. Look, so we've got, it's in the system table, so we've got lock screen sound enabled 0. So we would do this lock screen. I've spelt that wrong. Sound. Still spelt that wrong. And then save that. Oh, we'll have to change this DTMF. Let's use the drop down for that. Lock screen sound. Is it in here? Should be. Where is it? That's it, and then select it off, let's save, and then it's locked. So you can do that with just about any setting, so it's a really cool thing to play about with. Some settings in developer's options don't work. But again, that's because not every setting is stored in that table that set edit shows. But yeah, it's a pretty cool thing. So every phone is different, every device is different. So you've got different versions, you've got different carriers, you've got different apps, you've got different settings that are made available. So this allows MacroDroid to be more useful for different devices, rather than saying, right, we're going to check for one setting, and then if that setting's not stored the way that we expect it to be set, then obviously that wouldn't work. But this will work because it catches all three settings tables. So if I go back and get rid of this bit and just make it delete that, so it's just going to check everything,
and I'm going to save this and get rid of the system set in action. And the system set in action is really powerful. You can change all sorts of stuff as well. So you can change brightness, you can do the extra dim setting that's on newer phones.
There's just hundreds of different things you can do with it.
So system, setting. So here's the three tables. You've got system, secure and global. So if we do this, and then you've got the little drop down, you've got all these options you can change. So you can set the volume from here if you want it to, even if MacroDroid itself has an action to change the volume, but you can do that. Some devices, as an example, have an option to automatically
shut down
at certain times,
and that's usually built into the system settings of the device as opposed to MacroDroid. But you should be able to use this system setting change to catch the time changes that are made in the settings and change it back in the system settings with the system setting action. So you might be able to reboot and power off without root. One thing to be aware of with this system setting change thing, let's have a look. So the system settings action is that just because we're setting it to the settings table doesn't mean the device is listening for changes. So it might change in the table, but not the system might not, the phone, the device might not act on it. It depends. So don't expect every single setting to work, but it's such a powerful feature. You're gonna have some good fun with it. So anyway, right, I'll let you go, and thanks for watching. Bye bye.